Hello everyone, myself Rish Bhajan. I hope you all are fine and studying well at your home. Today we are going to revise the topics that we have studied in chapter 2, 4, operations. The topics that we have studied in chapter 2, 4, operations are 4 operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, word problems with irrelevant information, multi-step word problems with irrelevant information. Then we have done DMAS and average. Now we are going to revise the topics and subtopics one by one. At the starting of the chapter, we have studied there are 4 basic operations. First, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Then we have studied about their symbol. The symbol of addition is this: subtraction, multiplication, and division. Then we have studied the terms related to these 4 operations. There are 2 terms of addition: addends and sum. Addends are the numbers that will be added, and the sum is the outcome, or we can say the result of the addition. Then in subtraction we have 3 terms: minuend, subtrahend, and difference. Minuend is the greater number from which the smaller number will be subtracted. Subtrahend is the smaller number that will be subtracted from minuend. And the difference is the outcome, or we can say the result of the subtraction. Next we have done 3 terms in multiplication: multiplicand, multiplier, and product. Multiplicand is the greater number that will be multiplied. Multiplier is the number, smaller number that will multiply, and the product is the outcome, or we can say the result of the multiplication. In division, there are 4 terms: dividend, divisor, quotient, and remainder. Dividend is the number that will be divided. Divisor is the number that will divide, and the outcome will be 2, quotient and remainder. Now we are going to do the subtopics that we have studied in these 4 basic operations. In addition and subtraction, we have done the subtopics: estimating sum and difference, addition and subtraction strategies. For revising this concept, you can refer the videos chapter 2 part 1 and chapter 2 part 2. In multiplication, we have done the subtopics: multiplication by 10 and its multiple, and multiplication by keeping zeros in our mind. For revising this concept, you can refer video chapter 2 part 4. In division, we have done the subtopics: division by 10 and its multiple, and estimating quotient. For revising this concept, you can refer video chapter 2 part 5. After 4 basic operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, we have done the word problems. In these word problems, we have done 3 types of word problems with irrelevant information, multi-step word problems with irrelevant information. In this word problem with irrelevant information, there was some information that was not required for finding the answer. So, we will ignore the irrelevant information and then find the answer. Second, multi-step word problem. Many times the word problem can have many steps to solve the answer. So, this is the multi-step word problem. Multi-step word problem with irrelevant information. These kind of problems are there where the answer will be found by solving in many steps and by ignoring the irrelevant information also. For knowing more about it, you can go and see chapter 2 part 6 again. All 4 operations separately, we have learned DMAS, in which we have studied that what will be the sequence to solve the operation if all 4 operations or more than one operation will be in same question. To solve this, we will follow the sequence DMAS. First, we will divide. So, if 16 divided by 4 is 4, and rest will remain same. Then M, multiply. So multiply 2 into 3, it will be 6, and rest will remain same. Then add. 6 plus 4 is 10, minus 2. And then at last we will subtract. 10 minus 2 is 8. It was the portion in which we were having all operations together. But it can also be possible we have more than one operation, but all four are not there. So what will we do? We will check first divide. It is not present in this question, so you can skip. Multiply. So 4 into 3 will be 12 and rest will remain same. Then we have add, but we are not having addition there, so you can skip. And last, subtraction. So you will subtract. 12 minus 6 will be 6. At last, we have studied average. The formula for average is sum of terms upon number of terms. We are going to take one example to explain it. Find the average of the following terms: 8, 4, 6, 2, 5. By using this formula, average equals to sum of terms upon number of terms, we can find its average. How? The numerator will be the number of sum of terms. So 8 plus 4 plus 6 plus 2 plus 5. Upon the number of terms. How many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there will be 5. After adding it, you will get 8, 4, 12, plus 6, 18, plus 2, 20, plus 5, 25 upon 5. And we have learned when you will divide 25 by 5, it will be 5. So we can say the 5 is the average of these terms. Now, I just want to inform you that you have to revise all the topics for operations, word problems, DMAS, average and their subtopics, exercise 2A and 2H and mental maths of page number 77 of chapter 2 in rough notebook for test. It means there is a test tomorrow of the chapter 2. I hope you all will work hard and get good marks in test. Now, before winding today's class, I just want to say stay home, stay safe, and please like and subscribe my channel to get the notification for the latest update as soon as possible. And viewers, kindly mention your name, class, and section in comment box. Thank you.